Welcome to Edisla, where exploration knows no bounds. We encourage you to dream big and push the boundaries of imagination. Much like the Kardashev Scale challenges our understanding of what civilization could achieve, imagine a future where we evolve to harness the energy of entire stars, galaxies, or even multiple universes. The Kardashev Scale maps out this incredible journey from our current state to the speculative realms of cosmic power. From our modest origins, where we first tamed the flickering flames, to the grand visions of harnessing the energy of entire stars and galaxies, and perhaps one day exploring the mysteries of multiple universes. At Edisla, we believe in dreaming big and exploring the endless possibilities of the universe.
So, let's start with the basics. A Type 1 civilization, on this grand scale, is one that's mastered the energy output of its home planet. Think about that for a second. Every lightning strike, every volcanic eruption, every gentle breeze, all harnessed and under their control. This means complete mastery of not just renewable energy sources like solar, wind, and geothermal, but also control over the planet's natural phenomena. Imagine a world where earthquakes are predictable and hurricanes are steered away from populated areas. Now, you might be thinking, hey, we're nowhere near that. And you're right, we're not. Currently, humanity sits at about a 0.7 on the Kardashev scale. But hey, we've got ambition, right? And with advancements in fusion power, global energy interconnectivity, and sustainable technologies, Type 1 status might not be as far off as we think. Hold on to your hats, folks, because things are about to get really wild. A Type 2 civilization on the Kardashev scale isn't content with just one planet's energy, they've set their sights on their star. We're talking about a civilization capable of building megastructures like Dyson spheres, hypothetical constructs that encompass a star to capture a significant portion of its energy output. Imagine the possibilities. With that kind of energy at their disposal, a Type 2 civilization could engage in interstellar travel, terraform planets, and even manipulate the very fabric of space-time. Now you might be thinking, hold on, Neil, isn't that a bit far-fetched? And you know what? You're right to be skeptical. Achieving Type 2 status would require overcoming immense technological hurdles and likely involve scientific breakthroughs we can only dream of today. But hey, that's what makes the Kardashev scale so fascinating. It pushes the boundaries of our imagination and forces us to confront the sheer potential of advanced civilizations.
Buckle up, because we're entering the realm of science fiction with a Type 3 civilization. This is where things get truly mind-bending. As we're talking about, a civilization that's spanned an entire galaxy, tapping into the energy output of billions of stars. Think about the implications. A Type 3 civilization would possess technology so advanced it would seem like magic to us, capable of manipulating black holes, creating wormholes, and perhaps even altering the fundamental laws of physics. They would have likely transcended our understanding of biology and existence, possibly existing as digital consciousnesses or beings of pure energy. The sheer scale of their influence is almost impossible to comprehend. Imagine a civilization spread across billions of star systems, connected by instantaneous communication, and capable of harnessing the energy of entire galaxies. Chapter 4. Type 4. Civilization, Masters of the Universe. Hold on tight as we venture even further into the realm of the theoretical A-Type 4 civilization. Now, we're talking about a civilization so advanced that it controls energy on a scale that dwarfs even a galaxy. Imagine harnessing the power of dark matter, manipulating the cosmic microwave background radiation forces we're only just beginning to understand. A Type 4 civilization wouldn't just inhabit the universe, they would, in a sense, become one with it. They might exist across multiple dimensions, perceive time non-linearly, and possess the ability to create and destroy universes at will. Their technology would be indistinguishable from magic, their actions potentially shaping the very fabric of reality itself. Of course, at this level, we're deep into the realm of speculation. But the Kardashev scale isn't really about predicting the future. It's about pushing the boundaries of our imagination and asking, what if?
Chapter 5, Type 5. Civilization Beyond the Known Universe. Fasten your seatbelts, because we're about to blast off into the truly uncharted territories of the Kardashev scale, a Type 5 civilization. This isn't just about harnessing the energy of a universe. It's about transcending the very limitations of a single universe and tapping into the potential of the multiverse. Imagine a civilization capable of manipulating the fundamental constants of nature across multiple universes, perhaps even creating new universes with their own unique laws of physics. They would exist outside of space and time as we understand it, their thoughts shaping the very fabric of reality. Now I know what you're thinking. Neil, are you pulling my leg with this one? And you know what? You're right to be skeptical. A Type 5 civilization is pure speculation, a thought experiment pushed to its absolute limit. But even if such a civilization is beyond our comprehension, the very concept forces us to confront the vastness of the unknown and the potential for existence beyond our wildest dreams.
Chapter 6. Is it possible? A cosmic reality check. So, we've journeyed through the mind-blowing possibilities of the Kardashev Scale, from harnessing the power of planets to controlling the energy of entire universes. But now, let's take a step back and ask ourselves, is any of this truly possible? Well, when it comes to Type 1, I'm cautiously optimistic. With advancements in renewable energy, global cooperation, and a little bit of luck, I believe humanity can reach that milestone within a few centuries. Type 2, though, that's where things get tricky. Building a Dyson sphere, harnessing the power of a star, those are feats that would require technological leaps we can barely fathom. And as for Type 3, 4, and 5, those are firmly in the realm of science fiction, at least for now. But hey, who knows what the future holds? Maybe, just maybe, there are civilizations out there millions of years ahead of us, civilizations that have already achieved these unimaginable feats. The point of the Kardashev Scale isn't necessarily to provide a roadmap for the future, but to ignite our imaginations and inspire us to explore the vast possibilities that lie ahead. So keep looking up at the stars, keep asking questions, and never stop wondering what's out there.
Thanks for joining us on this journey through the Kardashev Scale. It's been a wild ride, hasn't it? From harnessing the power of our planet to contemplating the existence of multiversal civilizations, we've pushed the boundaries of our imaginations and explored the awe-inspiring possibilities of the universe. Remember, the Kardashev Scale isn't just about categorizing civilizations. It's about inspiring us to dream big, to push the limits of our knowledge, and to never stop exploring the vast unknown. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to Edisler for more fascinating content.